So you've covered a lot of themes inside your book, and we've had a number of writers also that have been guests of the Dax Collection, and myself also as a poetry writer and performer writing about experiences with mental health and what mental health illness can be like and overcoming or getting through that, the whole gamut. Would you like to talk about perhaps how you've written about that or approached that in your poetry collection? What was that like for you?
So this book was written over the years of 2011 to 2013. I'd been diagnosed since 2008 with schizophrenia. Yeah. In 2009, I was then diagnosed with depression. Mm. So multiple mental health issues.
Schizophrenia sort of, it can affect our thoughts a lot, but depression, it can really hit us in the chest, almost like a physical pain.
Certainly, yes. Yeah. I mean, those days I couldn't get out of bed and couldn't get myself to do anything, function properly or even do the washing, wash my hair, yeah. Look after yourself, the basic needs that you struggle doing when suffering from an illness.
And was that hard to connect with people during that time, because like, to meet you, you know, you're a very bright and bubbly person, you know, I mean bubbly in a beautiful sense of just, you know, giving a sense of happiness to people around you and very friendly and approachable. Was it hard for people to see, you know, what was going on for you?
So at the time I was sort of in my early 20s. And I was very isolated. I was living in Tasmania, mm. Moved away from my hometown of Sydney, and I was quite suicidal and was a different person. I was just suffering, really suffering.
Yeah, I had a period in my life where I was suicidal and ended up checking myself into a psychiatric ward for a few weeks to get through that period. But I remember thinking in retrospect, you know, once I got well, that period was like a deep illness, and that the thoughts that seemed so pertinent and like an option, you know, a viable option, many months later when I started to get well, I sort of shook my head and wonder a bit, you know, like how was I thinking that, you know, so realistically that was an option when, you know, not, as we all know, we only get the one life. Yeah.
Well, that's debatable, but
that's true in a spiritual sense. Yeah.
Yeah, reincarnation, but depression was a major issue, and as schizophrenic, it just mainly affected my ability to see what was real, and I was just living in a dreamland, and the lines between reality and unreality were definitely non-existent. Living in a fantasy world. And
how long did that continue for you?
I started receiving proper treatment at about 2010 to 2012, between 10 and 10 and 2012. I was on and off medication. Put on 20 kilos since taking medication. I used to be quite a slim young thing. Yeah. But it's, physical problems are not as bad as mental problems. So I'd rather be overweight and healthy in the mind than...
Yeah. Well, may I say that you don't appear exceedingly overweight at all. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
comparatively.
So how did you access that treatment? Like, was it through community or medical services?
So it started at university. I was referred to a psychologist. Then after seeing them, they referred me to a GP to get a referral to a psychiatrist. I received ongoing treatment from a local psychiatrist in Tasmania and also received counselling for drug abuse.
Did you find a good counsellor?
Not really, no.
Yeah, That's the hard part sometimes, is to find someone that you can connect with. And yeah, we've got a program on 3CR that talks about drug abuse as well. And you know, most people that, I think most people in the community have experiences with, you know, recreational drugs these days. Yeah.
Growing up in Sydney, Western Sydney. Western Sydney is a high risk area.
Yeah, I grew up in the western suburbs of Melbourne, you know, and I was exposed to marijuana probably by the age of 14.
Mm.
Yeah, at high school. Yeah.
14, yeah, that sounds about right.
Well, you've had a long journey since then, and I think you've been through a lot of changes, and you've grown very positively, and you've put out this wonderful book.
Definitely.
And I really thank you for, you know, sharing that discussion and openly with myself, and I share the same back, you know, for the reason too that we know there's many listeners out there experiencing exactly the same that we've experienced it, and that's why we talk about it, you know, so, you know, so it's not there in silence, and that people can feel like they're not so alone that are going through that.
Yeah.
Is there anything else you'd like to say?
If you don't feel 100% most of the time and you don't feel happy, seek help.
Yeah.
Talk to someone. And sometimes it takes the words of another person, such as your mother, to point you in the direction of leading a more fulfilling life.
Yeah. And we can't be happy all the time, really, can we?
No.
It's a balance. You know, sometimes I actually get a bit anxious if I get too happy, because I know I'm going to come down at some stage. Yeah.
What goes up must come down.
Would you like to read another poem for us, please?
Certainly.
So you're listening to Philippa Sue Richardson on Spoken Word on Community Radio 3CR.
This poem is one of my favourites and has been read around Melbourne at different venues. It's called Walk Another Day. Walk another day. Run another year, pass another play, time another fear. Useless as a paper, fooling neighbour's lair, wrong another writer, strike along the tear. Address them proper, amazed as to why, rip the stopper, dragging over dry. Not a good guideline, hasn't made the grade, bad use of sideline, disposable degrade. Wasn't as good as Sandy, wasn't as bad as Joel. In the hands of Mandy, a marker's filling bowl. A problem with the printing, typing out a month. Hasn't gone one stinting, thanks the pleasing bunch. Place it on the table, bring a better drink. Making neat the cable, finding what you think. There are those who believe, there are those who say they've seen. There are those who would dream, there are those who know they've been. Listen to the speaker, side by side again. Trouble minds are weaker, stirring in the brain.
Wow, you really made those words swing. That was good. Great steady rhythm there. Thanks, Philippa.
Well, it takes a lot of rehearsal and practice. Oh, Lover's Dance. That's a good one.
In white satin, never reaching the end. Letters I've written, never meaning to send. Beauty I'd always missed with these eyes before. Just what the truth. I can't say anymore, 'cause I love you. Yes, I love you. Oh, I love you. Gazing at people, some hand in hand. Just what I'm doing. can understand. Some try to tell me thoughts they cannot defend. Just what you want to be, you will be in the end, and I love you.
Lovers dance. Equal-sided, so divided. So much passion, handsome ration. Just a chance, lovers dance. Perfect timing, keep on climbing. Spark another, see my mother. Buy some food, superglued. Speak to you, over two. Slept at night, avoid a fight. All tomorrow, something borrowed. Have a smoke, enjoy the joke. Sleep in bed, nightly fed. Seek a chance, find romance. A bookshop shelf, find self-help. Almost dying, number one. Time to sleep, her to keep. Feeling sick, life's a prick. Done today, life delayed. Sister married, so much varied.
You're listening to Philippa Sue Richardson on Community Radio 3CR's Spoken Word, and we're getting towards the end of the program. Time for one more piece, perhaps, Philippa.
I'd like to read the very first poem in Life, Love and Everything, titled Not So Inspired. Not so inspired, feeling undesired, laying it to rest, written her own best, hard enough to try, tagged another by, rhyme another reason, falling out of season. Nothing seems the same, tortured all to blame, feel like fading fast, drop down to last. Trying to fill the page, sets on second stage, makes a little sense, pictures are immense. It's just no good, hazards should. Finished there, without a care, hidden bare, still nowhere.
Thank you, Philippa, for coming on Spoken Word. And is there anything else you'd like to say about where people can access your material? Perhaps just mention the main website they can go to again.
So there's Facebook page, Life, Love and Everything. There's also a second book coming out titled Symptomatic Addict, which is soon to be available on Amazon.com.
Great. Well, thank you for being our guest today.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
Them that's got shall have, them that's not shall lose. So the Bible said, and it still is news. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own, that's got his own. Yes, the strong gets more, while the weak ones fade. Empty pockets don't ever make the grade. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own. That's got his own. Money, you've got lots of friends. They're crowded But when you're gone and spending ends, they don't come no more. Rich relations give, crust the bread and such. You can help yourself, but don't take too much. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own, that's got his own.